Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's look at the differences between quitting an app, hiding an app, and closing a window. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So a lot of times I hear users, particularly new Mac users, getting confused about what happens when they quit an app. And sometimes it comes down to the fact that they're not actually quitting the app. They're just closing a window. And there's a big difference between closing a window and quitting an app on a Mac. In addition, there's a third alternative that I use more than either one of those, and it's to simply hide the app. So here I am working in an app, in this case Safari, and I've got one window open. Let's say I want to get rid of that window. I'm done using this document, or in this case a web page, for now, and I want it to go away. Well, there are three main ways to do that. The first, and the way a lot of people do it, is to go and click on this red button. What this will do is close this window, but it will not quit the app. This is very confusing, particularly for people that have used Microsoft Windows for a long time and have only recently switched to Macs. They would expect clicking the red button to actually quit the app. But if you see here, I click it and I'm still running Safari. The menu is still there. I can actually go to the menu and do things like, say, open up a new window. On Macs, closing the last window used by an app doesn't quit the app. This is how it's always worked on Macs. It doesn't assume that just because you close the last window that you're done using the app. Maybe I'm closing this window just to open a new one. For instance, if I was using Pages, I might close a document and then want to go and open another one to start working on it. Quitting the app Pages would be inconvenient because then I'd have to relaunch it. Now, if I really wanted to quit the app, the way to do that is go to the menu item with the name of the app, and then go to the quit item there. In this case, quit Safari. Or most people just use the keyboard shortcut Command Q. When I do that, the window goes away and the app has definitely quit. It's gone. But what can also be confusing to a lot of people is when I launch that app again, the window I was using reopens with the exact same size and the exact same spot with the same contents. If it was a Pages document, that Pages document would be here. In this case, it's a web page. That web page is reloaded. There are several ways to control that. One is when you go to quit, if I hold down the Option key, you could see quit changes to quit and close all windows. Or I could use the keyboard shortcut Option Command Q. And this will close that window, quit the app, and when I launch the app the next time, it runs like no windows were previously open. So if I was using Pages, Numbers, or Keynote, for instance, it would prompt me to open up a new document. Here in Safari, it's just going to open up a blank window, not go back to the same web page. I could also go to System Preferences, and under General, I can select Close Windows when quitting an app. If I turn that on, it works the same way as holding the Option key down when I quit. All windows will be closed every time I quit an app, and every time I launch the app again, it will start off fresh. Now there's a third way to get rid of the app and the windows, and this is what I use most of the time. And it's instead of going to quit, use Hide. The keyboard shortcut for that is almost always Command H. If you use that, it looks like you just quit the app. The window went away. The app is no longer visible, but the app is still running. If I go down to the dock here, I can see a dot under Safari. It's still running. And if I click on it, instantly I get the app back, and this window and any other windows I had opened will reappear. It doesn't reload the page. It doesn't have to reopen a document. It was always there. It was always open. It was just all hidden. It has a lot of the benefits of quitting, but the added advantage that I'm instantly able to go back into working with the app. Now if you've been using computers for a long time, you may think, well, it's not good to have the app running in the background like that. It's going to take up memory. It's going to take up processor time. But it really doesn't on modern computers. Modern computers know that a hidden app really should kind of be paused. It's not really doing much in the background. That depends a little bit on the type of app, what it's doing, and all of that. But for the most part, you can hide a lot of apps. I usually have several apps hidden at any time with only the one or two that I'm using at the moment visible. Very rarely do I actually quit an app. Matter of fact, I would probably never quit Safari. I'm always doing something on the web. I never quit Mail. Maybe if I'm working on a document in Pages and I'm finished and I know I'm not going to be using Pages for the rest of the day, maybe not even sure if I'm going to be using it tomorrow, then maybe I'll quit the app. But if I at all think I'm going to be using that app anytime soon, I just hide it. Now hiding and quitting, as long as you don't have this checkbox here checked so windows aren't closed, are very useful if you like the positions of windows of things. So for instance, if I'm working in Safari here and I've got this window here, and let's say I open up a new Safari window and I've got that over here as well, then if I were to hide the app with Command H and bring it back, those are still in the same positions. Of course they are. They were just hidden before. If I go to quit and then I relaunch Safari, those return to the same positions as well. But if I have that option checked in System Preferences, or I use the Option key when quitting here so it closes all windows, or I just close these windows like that, then when I bring up Safari again, you can see I don't get all my windows back. It's going to give me one window in one of those positions, but it's not going to get me back to where I was. And the same thing is true if I do full screen. So if I take Safari full screen here like this, and then I close the window like that, go to Safari again, you can see it opens up as a window. It doesn't go back to full screen. So in full screen mode, you want to move to another desktop, or you want to quit the app and relaunch it, rather than actually using the red button to close the window. When you hide an app, using the app switcher is another great way to get back to it. You just use Command H for hide, and then when you want to go back to the app, you use Command Tab, go to the app you want, and when you select it, if the app is hidden, it simply reappears. A good rule of thumb is never use the red button to close a window without first thinking about it. Do you really want to close this document, to close this window? On the other hand, using Command H to hide, you could do without thought. It's easy and instant to bring everything back. And only quit that app if you don't think you're going to be using it at all for the next few hours or the rest of the day. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.